Can I ask one question?
Yeah, sure.
Are you woman?
No, no, I'm a man.
Why? How do we know?
Well, you can say it from my appearance. And you see my beard, mustache,
oh,
and my dressing style.
Oh.
Yo, my dressing style may not help you though, but yes, I will surely say I'm a man.
Are you man?
Sorry?
Are you man?
No. Are you? I'm a man. What did you ask?
Are you a man?
No, I'm not.
Are you woman?
No.
How do I know?
You want to check it now, huh?
Are you a bisexual?
I don't think so.
You don't think so. Are you a gay? Are you a bisexual?
Yes. No, bisexual. I like only my wife.
Are you a man?
No, I'm not a man.
Why?
Why I am not a man? Because I'm a woman.
Okay.
The moment when people know I'm working with the LGBTQI community, which is a lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer, and intersex community. They ask me funny questions. Are you a gay? Are you a bisexual? Hey, no, you must be a transgender. These type of questions ask me in different occasions. Why should I answer those questions? Are we not a human beings? Male, female, transgender. Those type of gender identity and sexual orientation are given by the society. The most important thing is that we all are human beings and we all need to be treated equally. My name is Parthasarathy. I am from Tamil Nadu, India. I am a founder of the organization called Aravan. Aravan is working for the rights of LGBTQI community in Virudhunagar district. Let's look at the global scenario. The Universal Human Rights Council is grave concern about violations and discriminations based on sexual orientations and gender identities that are taking all over the world. The reality is that LGBTQI community still subject to discrimination, violations, torture, kidnapping, and even though murder. In 76 countries, same-sex relationship is criminalized. In 13 countries, being gay or bisexual is punishable by death. This systemic abuse must stop. We must protect the basic human rights. Let's go to India. Indian Penal Code 377. There are few fun facts in the 377. 377 is old and regressive law introduced by British. It says that leaving your natural territory and inserting yourself to other place, it's a crime. By the way, 377 is applies to heteros as well. According to this definition, I quote that the boy can only inserting his Indian culture into natural female values. So definitely no oral sex. And absolutely no porn. Gay sex is apparently viewed as a crime. It's worse than rape. The punishment for the rape is 7 years jail, but unnatural sex gets 10 years imprisonment. The extra 3 years comes because it's consent. to understand the reality of the LGBTQI community, I would share something about Murugan, who is a transgender. She is living in the small town in the Virudhunagar district. She has lot of harassment all the way through her childhood, including her family. She dropped out this school at the fourth standard because of bullying. Her livelihood, she must do sex work to earn money, as she unable to get job. Like Divya, there are more than 2000 LGBTQI community living in Virudhunagar district. I have been working with them for past 7 years. It started during my train journey to Kanyakumari in 2009, where I met two transgenders who were begging among the passengers. They told me they had been neglected by family and relatives. They had no shelter, no work. You think it's very difficult. I felt the need to serve them. I involved in 2009 in an LGBTQI project, which focused on HIV/AIDS. I see myself as a bridge between LGBTQI community and mainstream society. I am a door opener to fight for their rights. I can empathize with the LGBTQI community because I experienced discrimination myself through poverty, poor living with my mother and my brother. My father exploited each of us financially. We worked to give him money. We suffered. He laughed at us. You think how it's painful us? Today, I even discrimination I feel by my closest friends because I am working for and with the LGBTQI community. Aravan wants to see a world wherein LGBTQI community are treated equally. To realize this vision, Aravan will create inclusive environment. We will ensure the socio-economic and political development. We are focusing on their legal rights, access to healthcare, reduce the violation and improving the livelihood opportunity with the help of ICT mobile technology. Aravan plans to make a mobile application to connect the people and to provide the services. Aravan will form a solidarity groups and equip them with various awareness and human rights training programs. A 24/7 support team and resource center will be established. Do you remember? 1 month ago, we were standing in the long queue in the front of the ATM machine, panicking that we would not get cash just because the government devalued 500 and 1,000 rupee notes. We had the feeling it was a big crisis. At the same time, not far from here, in Chennai, a transgender was burned alive in the front of the police station just because the person did not want to be labeled, just because the person could not or did not want to answer the question, "Are you a man? Are you a woman?" Thank you.